Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath, author of Candida Crusher, formulator of the CanXida range of supplements. Today we're going to talk about systemic yeast infection again. How do you know if you've got a systemic yeast infection? So you know, all right, you all know. But to start with, you won't be on this computer listening to this video unless you're in a hospital bed. You'll probably have serious fever and chills, and especially if they're non-responsive to medication. So as I mentioned in a previous video, this is a commonly confused area where a lot of people I see actually believe they've got systemic candida. They haven't got systemic candida at all. They've got gastrointestinal yeast infection. So I'm going to read out a list I've got up here of the people who are more prone to getting a systemic yeast infection, or most prone. People with a central venous catheter. So if you've had a catheter put in your chest, or in your neck, if you're in hospital, you've got a line there. So often, just by putting this line in alone makes you a sitting duck for a yeast infection. Many healthcare workers actually transfer candida from one patient to another. So just being in a hospital alone significantly increases your risk of a systemic yeast infection. So don't go to hospital. Try and keep out of these damn things. Patients in the intensive care unit, of course, with a lot of invasive procedures, have a higher risk. People who have weakened immune systems, for example, organ transplant, HIV, AIDS, or on cancer chemotherapy. People who've taken broad-spectrum antibiotics. Why would you even want to take antibiotics in the first place? I've talked many times about how ridiculous it is that people get them for a little cut on their finger, they'll get put for 10 days on penicillin. Just use flippin' tea tree oil. It's going to work, okay? People have a very low neutrophil count. So neutropenia is a condition we find often with people with suppressed immune function. This very commonly occurs again with people on various medications. People who have kidney failure or who are on hemodialysis are also at a higher risk. People who've got diabetes, and also people who've had different kind of surgeries are more prone. Have you noticed how a lot of these things I'm saying are linked with the medical system? You know, operations, medications. So once you get sick, there is a high chance you could get sicker and sicker and sicker. So I believe that hospitals are not a good place to get well. Okay, it's good to stay out of the hospital. Hospitals have potential to make you sicker. They're a great place for broken bones, or if you've fallen, you know, you're drunk and you've fallen off a balcony or something like that, then you need to go to hospital. You've cut your hand off in the power saw, then you need to go to hospital. You know, things like that. But be careful. Because many medical procedures, if you can avoid them, may be linked with, you know, seriously weakening your immune system and increasing your risk. There are many super infections in hospitals now and bugs. I can't tell you how many people I've seen who've had a medical procedure, who've come out of hospital, and who've never been well since. And it could take 6 or 12 months to get them back, you know, in full health again. So what was the question again? How do you know if you've got a systemic yeast infection? You're going to be seriously sick if you've got one. Chances are you probably won't have one. You'll have a gastrointestinal yeast infection, or you'll have a vaginal one, or a toenail, or jock itch, or, you know, other kind of a skin infection, but you probably won't have one affecting you systemically. And they pick it up, the diagnosis is by a blood test. It'll be basically picked up in a couple of days. You'll get the lab report back, and that's how you know if you've got one. I'd be careful of people who also believe that they can diagnose yeast infection with live blood cell analysis. I don't really believe that it's possible to do that. And if you do go to a practitioner who does live blood cell analysis and tells you that you've got candida in your bloodstream, I'd be very wary of those kinds of people, because I can't really see a lot of science behind that. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to click on the link below in the description box if you want my report, if you haven't already got it. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for tuning in.